Gusto News on Gusto TV. My name is Andy. I know the news this time. I've got Davido closely followed by Bad Boy Teams, and I'm rounding up the news with Joe Boy. But before I go on, it's a tradition here to say a very big thank you for the likes and the comments on this channel. And also, if you're new to the channel, kindly subscribe and hit the post notification bell so that you get notified each time we drop a new video. Just look beneath this video, you get to see, you know, the button and the bell there. So just hit it so that you get notified. So straight on to the news, starting up with Davido, talking about Nigeria's hottest artist. Is he? Well, Davido is on the news this time because of, you know, an event that happened while at the airport. You know, Davido, you know, trying to fly his private jet, and then people, you know, wanting to take pictures with him, which is actually norm with celebrities. You know, when they go out, when they move out, people, you know, come around, you know, beg them for pictures, you know, want to have autographs and all. So this thing is known around the world. And also, you know, these celebrities don't just walk alone when they go out. Definitely they have people who go with them. You know, they have the likes of their bouncers, you know, the really big guys and huge guys who go around with them, also to protect them, also to protect their privacy and things like that. Well, something similar happened to Davido at the airport. You know, one of the airport staff actually, you know, wanted to take a picture with Davido, and then he just, you know, went into the way and then just went in front of him and was like, you know, he wanted to take pictures. And as expected, obviously his bouncer was there to, you know, to like, okay, you know what, keep your distance. And then, you know, according to people, according to reports, you know, they said the bouncer, you know, manhandled him and then shoved this, you know, this staff aside. And also, you know, people were, you know, people came out to say, you know, why would the bouncer do that? Now, why would Davido's bouncer do that? Why would he, you know, just chase off someone just like that? Why would he just push out someone like that? And there are also people going out to say that, well, this guy is doing his job. You don't just bring out a camera in front of a celebrity and then you just want to start taking pictures just like that. You need to have consent. You know, people going on to say, with using the word consent, consent is very important. You know, the person has to agree to want to take a picture with you. And also, well, people obviously are saying these are the moments, you know, there were different reactions. You know, we had a few comments here. This one saying, it's a normal thing, he's just doing his job at Ninja Copa, as that one said. It's a normal thing, you know, the bouncer was just doing his job. And then this other person said, the moment singer Davido's bodyguard was seen doing his work. So this person is trying to say, it's, you know, blogs have been saying his bodyguard manhandled him and pushed him outside. So people have also the opinion that, you know what, why about we put it this way? What we say, this bouncer was actually doing his work and then trying to, you know, protect the privacy of Davido at that moment. So moving on to the next one. Well, this one, someone also agrees to what the person says. He says it's rude just to put a camera in someone else's face without permission or consent. Regardless of celebrity status or not, the bodyguard was just doing his job. So obviously agreeing again, you don't just put the camera in front of anyone irrespective of your status, either celebrity or not. And the bouncer again was doing his job. So with all these whole reactions and everything as regards this one, you know, a new release, or rather a new development has happened as regards this. Well, Israel DMW is one of Davido's aide also put out a picture or a photo of this same you know, this same airport staff taking a picture with Davido in his private jet. So what actually happened after all this had conspired, after all these things had happened, you know, Davido actually invited this guy to his jet to take a picture with him, you know, after he had seen the whole ruffle and shuffle and everything that happened. You know, Davido was like, you know, I'm a man of the people. You know, I've always said, you know, you help, you rise by lifting others. I always love being around my fans. I always love being around people, you know, who love me. So you know what he did? He called out this guy, called him to his private jet and told him, you know what? You can take a picture, you can take videos with me as long as you want. And there you have it here. The airport staff really happy to take a picture with Davido, you know, giving up the sign there, like, peace, yeah, I'm in private jets with Davido. I'm taking a picture with Davido in his own jet. And then obviously, if you can see here, he's just all smiles and all happy, and Davido is just there. So you know what, just let's take this picture together. And so we have the caption here from Davido's aides talking about Israel DMW, who goes out to say baddest later called him inside for a photograph, and then he tags Instablog, which had actually been taking out the news of Davido, you know, manhandling and you know, just rather did those, you know, bodyguard manhandling and shuffling aside this particular airport staff. So he goes on to say, you know what, Baez actually called him back into the plane and told him to take a picture with him, and then, you know, they were all happy after everything happened. And then obviously he goes on to say that this particular guy, the airport staff, was also really happy to have gone into the plane, and then obviously all things, you know, they became really good at the end of the day. So big ups to Davido yet again for showing us what it's like to be a celeb. And then, you know what, you guys, you can love me as much as you want, just come on, it's Davido. I would always be there to take pictures with you anytime you want. So moving on to the next one, talking about Bad Boy teams. Yeah, Judelli Bese beating Michael Jackson, and also loading. So talking about this guy was really hot last year. So many songs from him last year were bubbling and breaking around, you know, breaking clubs inside the club. There's no way how you go into the club without hearing a song, you know, by Bad Boy teams, or a song that, you know, that featured Bad Boy teams in it. You know, we had Loading, which was featured by Olamide on that one, and that one was a club banger. Everybody playing Loading everywhere you went to. Well, it's been over a year since we've heard a song from Bad Boy teams. You know, there's been talks about him and his label and him not being able to release songs because of label issues and all that's been going around. Well, Bad Boy teams has come to his Twitter, you know, to talk about all these things, and then, you know, how he feels at the moment and the possibility of him releasing a song soon. So he goes on to his Twitter and brings out and he says a lot of things, and then this one says, every human being can tell how hot it is not to do what you love. For me, it's almost a year I've not put out music. Damn. I wake up to DMs and tweets of, where is Bad Boy teams every day? So he goes on to say, you know, people are wanting to find him. And then he goes on to say here that, in the next one, what I have, I promise you've not heard it anywhere else. Bad Boy teams is not back. Bad Boy teams never left. Oh, shock one back on spiritual. So also here he says, respect to everyone who has kept me going this past few months, my family, team, OGs, and most especially my fans. It is about time. It is really about time we ball on them. So he ends it all on this next one. He says, I decided to take this time to sit back and reflect on how far I have come within a year. Was this a good decision? Hell yeah. So a recap of all what Bad Boy teams is trying to say, you know, for the past 1 year or close to 1 year, you guys have not heard from me. And at that time, you know, I've been trying to reflect on myself and my music. Well, right now, you know what? Bad Boy teams never left. Bad Boy teams has always been here. Nobody say Bad Boy teams is back or Bad Boy teams never left. So probably soon we'll be hearing new things from Bad Boy teams. And you know what? We'll be here to give it to you once he drops a new one, or once he has, you know, any, once he announces the possibility of a new track. Like he has said, yeah, Bad Boy teams never left. Bad Boy teams is here, and then he's here to ball on us, according to him. So pretty soon we'll be hearing some new bangers by Bad Boy teams. Rounding up the news now with Joe Boy Pondek. Well, if you're going to be talking about songs currently making the charts in Nigeria, you'll definitely be talking about Alcohol by Joe Boy, which is currently number one on Nigerian Apple Music, currently number one, you know, doing so much wonders. And definitely one thing about this song is the challenge that has been going on TikTok. You know, people's vibing to Joe Boy's song, people, you know, pouring drinks on themselves, people doing different things. And in September, you know, Joe Boy came out to say that, you know what, guys, I know you guys love me, I know you guys love this song, but please, please, and please stop pouring alcohol on your body. That's what he had to say back then. Well, right now, you know, I guess people, they just get coconut head. They know they hear what. People still, you know, went on pouring drinks on themselves, and then they went a top notch, or rather, they went a step higher. You know, they took the step higher and the ladder, and then we had people not just pouring alcohol on their body, they started pouring, you know, they started things like bleach, you know, detergents and the likes, so an antiseptic also on their body. And Joe Boy has come out to say again, you know what, guys, have fun. I tell you people before, same one, I know they do this thing again. Well, he has come out to say this on his Twitter. He said, so in addition to not pouring stuff on your bodies, please stop ingesting unhealthy things too. Let's enjoy the song and stay alive. blessed. So he's going to say that, you guys, please, I said it before that you guys stop pouring things on your body, and right now you guys are drinking different things and pouring it on your body again. So what, in addition to me saying that you guys stop pouring things on your body, please stop taking in harmful substances into your body. And also another celebrity, probably a friend of Joe Boy, also has come on to say, talking about Black Bones on his Instagram. He also, you know, he agrees to what your boy is saying, and then he goes on to say on his Instagram story, he says, stop drinking harmful things in the name of challenges. Don't do it with anybody's song. It is not worth it. Stop. So Black Bones is saying, you know what? Stop drinking harmful things in because of challenges also. Just stop it. Just stop it. It's harmful. It's not good for the body. Just stop it. So guys, this is how, you know, I'll be rounding things up on the news this moment. You know, we had news on Davido, we also had news on Bad Boy Team, talking about him being back and him never leaving. And also there's Joe Boy's Alcohol, currently doing well in Nigeria, currently number one in Nigerian Apple Music. And Joe Boy went on to say, you know what guys, stop taking harmful substances all in the name of my song. Bless up, I love you all, but please stop taking harmful substances. So guys, that's how we're rounding things up on the news, and those were the main stories from the news. Remember, if you're new to the channel, kindly subscribe and hit the post notification bell so that you get notified each time we drop a new video. Until the next one, my name is Andy.